हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 18 ऑन नेटवर्क थ्योरी एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज रेजोनेंस इन एसी सर्किट। दिस फेनोमेनन दैट इज रेजोनेंस इज यूज्ड इन वेरियस डोमेन्स लाइक इन कॉन्स्ट्रक्ट इन इंडक्शन हीटर, RF एम्पलीफायर्स, टीवी रिसीवर्स, रेडियो, म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, माइक्रोवेव ओवन, ऑल दीज आर कॉन्स्ट्रक्टिव वन। Now there is one example, that is Tacoma Bridge collapsed in 1940 due to this phenomenon resonance. Why we have to study about resonance? Now resonance is the frequency response of a circuit or network when it is operating at its natural frequency called resonance frequency. Now, for many applications, the supply voltage and the frequency is basically constant. Say for example, the supply to residential home is 230 volt 50 hertz. However, many communication systems involve circuits in which the supply voltage operates with a varying frequency. Now, to understand communication systems, one requires a knowledge of how circuits are affected by a variation of the frequency. Examples of such communication systems are radio, television, telephones, and machine control systems. Now, resonance occurs in any circuit that has energy storage elements, at least one inductor and one capacitor. So that is the first condition that you have to remember. Now, the basic concept of resonance is that inductive reactance, that is the reactance of inductor, is a frequency dependent. As we know, XL is nothing but 2 pi FL. Now here, if F is increases, XL increases. But capacitive reactance, that is XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC, where if F increases, capacitive reactance decreases with higher frequencies. So these two has opposite nature. Inductor reactance increases with frequency, capacitive reactance decreases with higher frequency. Now, because of these opposite characteristics, for any LC combination, there must be a frequency at which the capacitive reactance and inductive reactance XL equal to XC. One increases while the other decreases. That is the reason. We can have one condition where XL equal to XC. Now, this case of equal and opposite reactance is called resonance, and the AC circuit is then a resonant circuit. So the frequency at which XL equal to XC is called the resonant frequency. Now at the resonant frequency, inductive and capacitive reactances are equal. Now in a series RC circuit, series AC circuit, RLC circuit, inductive reactance leads by 90 degree compared to with the zero reference angle of resistance, and capacitive reactance lags by 90 degree. So what we can say is XL and XC are basically 180 degree out of phase. The opposite reactances cancel each other and completely when they are equal. So let us study about the resonance in RLC series circuit. Now suppose this is a circuit, we have voltage source with RLC, those are connected in series, okay, single phase variable frequency F. Now total impedance of the circuit is what? Impedance nothing but R plus j omega L minus 1 by omega C. That is R plus j omega L minus j by omega C, okay. We are taking j as the common factor. Now total impedance is this one. So what is the impedance of the circuit in magnitude? This is in magnitude and angle. So R plus J of something, JX, say JX. So we can have angle also. Now say magnitude of X is nothing but root over of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square. And where the angle phi is nothing but tan inverse omega L minus 1 by omega C divided by R. And omega is nothing but 2 pi F. F is the supply frequency. Now current flowing is nothing but V supply frequency divided by Z. or prefers the triangle of minus pi. It can be plus also, depend on which one is higher, capacitive or reactance or inductive reactance. So we can find out I in terms of V by Z also. Here we are putting this Z value here. Now the current in the circuit, now what happened? Resonance occurs when the reactance term is equal to 0. That means omega L minus 1 by omega C equal to 0. Then omega L equal to omega C. Now if this term becomes 0, what will happen to Z? Z will be equal to R. Okay. So the condition is this reactance part you have to make 0. So omega L equal to 1 by omega C, that means XL equal to XC. So from this equation, what you can find out? You can find out that omega square equal to 1 by LC. So F resonant frequency is omega 0 divided by 2 pi, and omega 0 is 1 by root of LC. So F0 equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LC, or omega 0 equal to 1 by root of LC. So this condition under the magnitude of current is maximum. Because in this case, what happens? This reactance term becomes 0. That means what? Impedance, this term becomes 0 means impedance becomes lesser, which is equal to R. Then current will be maximized. So this condition under the magnitude of the current is maximum because resistance or impedance becomes only equal to R. Okay. As reactance is 0 or XL equal to XC. And in that case, what happened? It is only resistive circuit. It becomes a resistive circuit. So the phase angle is 0 or cos phi equal to power factor equal to 1. Okay. Now let us just observe this, the variation of XC and XL. Now XL equal to 2 pi FL, that means at F equal to 0, it is 0 and it is increased linearly. And XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC, when F equal to 0, it is infinity, so it is very high infinity. Okay. And when F equal to infinity, it will become 0, it goes to 0. Okay. Now this is your XC curve and this is your XL curve. Now what happens at this point when XA equal to XC, the series resonance occurs at this point. Now below this frequency, okay, what happens? It will be capacitive in nature, XC greater than XL, and after which it will be XL greater than XC, that means this inductive. So at resonant, the circuit becomes resistive. Below resonant frequency, it is capacitive, and after or higher than resonant frequency, it is inductive. Okay. And at resonance, it is equal to R. Now, say the function of frequency. Now, this is your XC, this is your XL, and say your Z value is like this. That means Z value is higher, it goes down, and at some point, it goes to the minimum. Then again it is increasing. But minimum point, this is equal to Z equal to R when XL equal to XC. Okay, at that particular frequency. Okay, so this is the response of Z with respect to frequency. At this point it is Z equal to R. Now at the resonant frequency, the voltage across capacitor and inductor are equal in magnitude. Since they are 180 degree out of phase with each other, they cancel and leaving 0 volt across LC combination. So this is the RLC series circuit. Now VC is say this one and VL equal to this one. So you can see these two are 180 degree out of phase. It is started from 0, but it is started from positive value. Positive cycle started from 180 degree. So it is 180 degree out of phase. And both are equal, so these two will cancel out, so it will be 0. X equal to 0. Now you can see this is VR, VL, VC. So between VR, VL, VL is 90 degree ahead or leading, VC is 90 degree lagging. So between VL and VC, that is 180 degree out of phase. Now the phase angle of RLC series circuit. So in here we can see this is for capacitive, that V and I is leading by 90 degree. for we are resistive circuit in phase with each other, and for inductive circuit, that is current is lagging. Okay. So at resonant frequency it is zero phase because it is R, and below that it goes from minus 90 degree to zero, after that it goes to plus 90. Okay. If it is RLC series circuit. Now the response curve for a series resonant circuit. Now current is maximum at resonant frequency. So, why? Because Z equal to R. Z is minimum, so current is maximum. So this is the current response. At resonant frequency it is maximum, and we can go down by 1 by root 2. That is the 2 points we got. Those two are the cutoff frequency F1, F2, and F2 minus F1 is the bandwidth. Now within the bandwidth of frequency, within the bandwidth of frequencies, the current is greater than 70.7% of the highest resonant value. It is normalized to 1. It can be in dB also. dB means it will be 20 log of V out by V in. Okay. Now that 70.7% cutoff is also referred as 3 dB point, minus 3 dB point. That means if it is 0, we have to go down by minus 3 dB point. It is also called half power point, because the power at F1 or F2 is that will be I square R. Now here at this F1 or F2, I is nothing but 0.707 of I max square R. So 0.707 whole square is nothing but 0.5. That will be 0.5 I max square R. So that is 0.5 P max. So at resonant, at the half power point, that is why it is for half power point, because here power becomes 0.5 of Pmax. Okay, where if you go down by minus 3 dB, or if you go down by 70.7% or 0.707 of the maximum current value. Okay, now the formulas of the bandwidth. Now bandwidth formula is nothing but this F2 minus F1, or you can say omega 2 minus omega 1. Okay. And ideally the center frequency FR or omega R, that will be equal to, that will be equal to omega 1 plus omega 2 divided by 2. Now according to some algebraic equation, so after solving algebraic equation, we can get the value of W1, okay, or F1. F1 is nothing but W1 equal to 2 pi F1, so F1 equal to 2 pi, here in this will be divided by 2 pi. Okay. So W1 is minus R by 2L plus root over of R by 2L square plus 1 by LC, and W2 is R by 2L plus root over of R by 2L whole square plus 1 by LC. And omega 0, which is nothing but the resonant frequency, which is root over of W1 into W2. Okay. Or you can represent it by frequency also. Bandwidth is nothing but W2 minus W1 or F2 minus F1, which is equal to R by L. And W1 or F1, that we can find out that FR, resonant frequency, minus bandwidth by 2. Okay. And F2 can be found out, FR plus bandwidth by 2. So W1 is nothing but W0 minus bandwidth by 2, or W2 is W0 plus bandwidth by 2. Now selectivity defines as how well a resonant circuit responds to a certain frequency and discriminates against all other frequencies. Now the narrower the bandwidth or steeper the slope, the greater is the selectivity. Thus this is related to the quality factor or performance of the inductor at resonance. So Q is the quality factor or selectivity, which is equal to reactive power divided by average power. Okay, that means Q equal to omega L divided omega 0 L divided by R, or 1 by omega RC. Now if you put omega value here, if you solve it, you will get 1 by R root of L by C. Omega value is 1 by root of LC. Okay. Then you will get 1 by root of L by C. So this is the quality factor. Again, quality factor we can calculate by using bandwidth. Now, bandwidth is what? Nothing but omega 0 resonant frequency divided by Q, or Q equal to omega 0 by bandwidth. That means if we find out this omega 0, that is resonant frequency, and if you find out Q, you can find out bandwidth. If you can find out bandwidth, right, and you know resonant frequency, then we can find out that omega 1, omega 2, that value we can find out, right? So this is how we can solve the problem, or we can find out W1, W2 using this resistance and capacitance value also, okay? Or bandwidth we can find out if you know the value of W and L. If you know bandwidth, then you can, if you know omega 0, resonant frequency, you can find out Q, okay? So this is the way you can find out. Now the comparative selectivity curve. Now according to this, what is said here, that narrower the bandwidth or steeper the slope, the greater is the selectivity. So here this curve shows that the band, this is narrower than this other two curve. So this bandwidth is BW1 for green curve, BW2, and for blue, that is BW3. That means the magenta color has the greatest selectivity than the other two, because bandwidth is smaller. That means it can select this particular frequency very well. There will be no other frequency components. It should be, as suppose you have to select one particular frequency, then this bandwidth must be very small, okay? So that is depend on quality factor. You have to raise the quality factor value. Now the main two concept that you have to remember, that is the voltage which appears across the reactive components can be many times greater than that of the supply. The factor of magnification, the voltage magnification in the series circuit, is called the Q factor. This is another definition of Q factor. Now RLC series circuit accepts maximum current while the impedance is minimum from the source at resonance, and for that reason it is called an acceptor circuit. Okay, so what are the main point of series resonance? That is impedance equal to R, which is the minimum at resonance, current is maximum. Now say for example, this is a RLC is given. Okay, now say you have to find out the resonant frequency. So resonant frequency is nothing but 1 by 2 pi root of LC, because 2 pi f R gives you the omega R, which is 1 by root of LC. If you calculate that, 2 microfarad and 20 millihenry, so we got the FR. Now if you know FR, that is resonant frequency, I we can find out, because at resonance I is maximum, that is V by R, so we got the value of I. Now XL we can find out 2 pi FL, right? So VL, voltage drop across inductor, that is I of XL, so we got the IL, that is equal to VL. Now that should be equal to VC. Okay, now Q factor we can find out using the formula XL by R. Okay, that is 100 by 30, where XL you got here. Why you are calculating XL? Because we can calculate Q factor directly, XL by R. Now from that we can find out bandwidth. Bandwidth is resonant frequency, that is already we got, and the value of quality factor Q. So you got the bandwidth. If you know bandwidth, you can find out the lower cutoff frequency and higher cutoff frequency. Now bandwidth, this is your F1, this is called lower cutoff frequency, and this is called higher cutoff frequency, and these two points we got from the maximum current to down by 70.7% of that. Okay, higher cell or minus 3 dB. Now FL, lower cutoff frequency can be resonant frequency minus bandwidth by 2, and half higher cutoff frequency, resonant frequency plus bandwidth by 2. So we got these two values. Now say we have a circuit, RLC is given, we have to find the resonant frequency. So that is resonant frequency omega z R you have to find out. So omega R equal to 1 by root of LC. If it is resonant frequency, then F, then it will be omega equal to 2 pi F. So F equal to, here you have to have 1 by 2 pi into root of LC. So you got the resonant frequency, and we have to find out half power frequencies. Half power means that W1, W2, we have to find out. So we can use this formula, that is minus R by 2L plus root of R by 2L whole square plus 1 by LC. We can find out that too also using that two formula. Okay. In previous case, we didn't use this formula. Okay. So W1, W2 we got, then bandwidth is nothing but this W2 minus W1. Okay. We got bandwidth. The quality factor is nothing but resonance frequency divided by bandwidth. So you got quality factor. It is very high, 25. Now at omega equal to omega R, I equal to what? Maximum voltage divided by R. Here in circuit it is given 20 sin omega t. So this is maximum voltage 20. So you got this current. And at omega and omega 2, at omega equal to omega 1, omega 2, what is the amplitude of current? I equal to Vm by root 2 R. So that should be reduced by 1 by root 2. So it will be 7.07. So it is 10 ampere at resonance goes down by 1 by root 2. Okay. So that will be 7.07. So now let us take another example. Say we have a circuit whose resistance is 4 ohm, inductance value is given, and variable capacitor connected across 10 volt 50 hertz supply. Now we have to calculate the capacitance required to produce series resonance condition and the voltage generated across both the inductor and capacitor at the point of resonance. So from this circuit problem, what you can find out? You can find out XL, that is 2 pi FL, because L value is given, frequency is 50 hertz. So 2 pi F into L, 500 millihenry. So you got XL. So if you got XL, we can find out IS at resonance condition, that is V by R, because R is also given. So you got I. Then what you can find out? Now, at resonance, we know VL equal to VC. So we can find out VL value. So VL is nothing but I into XL. XL already we got. And that should be equal to VC. So those values should be same. Now how to find out capacitance value? Now at resonance, what happened? XL should be equal to XL. We got value of XL. So that we have to put it here. So XC equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Now C is, we have to find out. So C goes here, XC comes here. So we can find out C equal to 1 by 2 pi FC, F X of C. Then we find out the value of C. Okay. Now say another problem, say the bandwidth of a series resonance circuit is 500 Hz. So bandwidth is given. If the resonant frequency is 6000 Hz, that is also given. What is the Q factor? Now bandwidth is nothing but resonant frequency by Q factor, or Q equal to resonant frequency bandwidth. Resonant frequency is given, bandwidth is given, we can find out Q factor. Now if R equal to 10 ohm, what is the value of the inductive reactance at resonance? Calculate the inductance and capacitance of the circuit. So Q is, we know Q is XL by R. So XL will be equal to Q into R. R is given. Okay. So we got Q value, XL value. So if you know XL, we can find out L value. XL equal to 2 pi FL, where FR is already given. So we find out XL. Now XL equal to XC at resonant condition. So we know XC value. Then we can find out C value. X equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. We know XC. So C value we can find out because resonant frequency we know. So that is how we can find out, knowing resonant frequency and bandwidth, you can find out Q factor, inductance value, capacitance value of the circuit. Okay. Now say another problem. In that case, it is given that a constant voltage of frequency 1 MHz is applied to a lossless inductor R in series with L, in series with capacitor C. Now the current drawn is maximum when C equal to 400 picofarad, while current is reduced to 1 by root 2 of the above value when C is 450 picofarad. Find the values of R and L. Also the quality factor of the coil and bandwidth. Now frequency is given 1 MHz, 2 per hertz. Omega is 2 pi F. C value is given 400 picofarad. Okay. So we can find out XC directly knowing the value of F and C. Okay. So we put this value, we got XC. Right. Now we have to find out the inductor value. Now inductor value will be equal to what? At resonant condition, XL equal to XC. So we can find out 2 pi FL equal to XL. So L we can find out. Right. Now, at C1, when C of C equal to 450 picofarad, XC1 equal to this value, right? So Z equal to, you can find out, it is R plus J of XC minus XL or XL minus XC. So you got this one. Now in that case, what happened? XL remains the value of XL remains the same, but C value changes. Okay. For that C, you have to find out that. So we got Z value. Then I equal to I max divided by root 2. That is 1 by root 2. Maximum by, reduced by 1 by root 2. So I max by root 2. So that will be V by root 2 R equal to VZ. So Z equal to this, so Z equal to root over R square plus this whole square, 44.3 whole square. Now, this root 2, now according to form this expression, what you can write, that is root 2 R equal to this particular term. From that, we can find, solving that, we can find out R value. Okay. And the quality factor is nothing but XL by R. XL already we know, R value that we have found out. So we got a Q. Now bandwidth is nothing but you can write R by 2 pi L. Using that formula, you can find out the bandwidth also. Now see resonance in RLC parallel circuit. Now in RLC series circuit, electrical resonance takes place when the voltage across the inductance is equal to the voltage across the capacitance. Alternatively, resonance takes place when the power factor of the circuit becomes unity. And this is the basic condition of resonance. It remains same for the parallel circuits also. Thus, the resonance will occur in parallel circuit when the power factor of the inter circuit becomes unity. Now, this is a parallel circuit RLC, three branches are connected in parallel with the voltage source. Okay. Now, at resonance, XC should be equal to XC. That means what? Imaginary parts of admittance becomes zero. So, from this circuit, we have to find out the admittance. Okay. Instead of impedance, we have to find out admittance. So the admittance, then what we can write, I equal to V into Y, right? Instead of V equal to IZ, we can write Z equal to 1 by Y. That means I equal to V into Y. So Y is nothing but admittance. Admittance means we have to find out admittance of R, that is 1 by R. This is XL is the impedance, so 1 by XL. And this is XC, or this is omega L, this is j omega L, so 1 by j omega L, and this is 1 by j omega C, that becomes 1 j omega C. Now see, this is admittance of resistance 1 by R, for in the capacitive reactance is 1 by j omega C, so then the inverse of that is j omega C, and inductive reactance is j omega L. Admittance is 1 by J. Now the condition is XC should be equal to XC. Now here we can write Y equal to G plus BL plus BC. Okay, so Y, or we can write according to this any one of the formula. Now XL equal to XC, that means if you solve it, we will get same formula that we got from series circuit, that is FR equal to 1 by root of 2 pi root of LC, 1 by 2 pi root of LC, or omega R equal to 1 by root of LC. Okay. Now, at resonance, the parallel LC circuit acts like open circuit. Okay, because it becomes zero. But with the circuit being determined by the resistors only. Okay, so the total impedance of parallel resonance circuit at resonance becomes just the value of the resistance in the circuit, Z equal to R. As soon, and these two becomes open. Now one thing you have to remember, that for series circuit, what happens when XL XC becomes zero, total impedance decreases, because here impedance is R plus j omega L plus 1 by j omega C, root over of that. Okay, so here when XL become XC, your Z equal to R, which is the minimum value for series resistance. But for parallel resistance, what happens? If you connect parallel resistances, the resistance, effective resistance value decreases. Suppose we have a resistance R 10 ohm, 10 ohm in parallel. Then if you, what is the equivalent resistance? That becomes 5 ohm. 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 10, so that will be 5 ohm. It becomes half of that. That means in parallel resistance decreases. Now what happens if these two becomes X, L, XL, XC equals, which will cancel each other, then the total effective resistance across this load, it will see the maximum resistance value, that is R. Okay. So in that case, what happened? According to the, if you plot frequency versus Z, we have maximum value at resonance, we have maximum resistance R. Okay. At below that, it will be capacitive, and after that, it will be inductive. Now, this is the point we have to remember. In series circuit, what happened? Impedance becomes lower, that is equal to R. But in parallel circuit, it becomes maximum, equal to R only, but becomes maximum. Then, in case of series circuit, what happens? Z equal to R minimum, so current is maximum. Here, Z equal to R become maximum, so current becomes minimum. Okay. So, that is the point that you have to remember, because of this parallel combination, the effective resistance basically reduces. And in series resistance, series connected, it will increase. Okay. For series connected, as resistance increases, if two resistance becomes equal, cancel each other, then that will be minimum resistance. Right? In parallel case, that is the opposite. That you have to remember. Now, here also the same kind of formula you have to write. Quality factor, it is the opposite of that. It is R by XL. In previous case, series case, that is XL by R. Okay. Bandwidth is same formula, resonant frequency by Q, or bandwidth equal to upper cutoff frequency minus lower cutoff frequency. And here bandwidth equal to 1 by RC also. And here Q, the W1, W2 value is different formula. Here 1 by 2 RC minus root of 1 by 4 R square T square plus 1 by LC. So this is the different formula that you have to remember. Now, quality according to bandwidth, so this here the current is lower cutoff frequency, higher cutoff frequency, and this is the plotted again AV, that is V out by V, not the current plot, and this is a maximized as 1, so we have to go down by 70.7. So this is your bandwidth, lower cutoff frequency, higher cutoff frequency. Okay. Now say resonance in parallel RC circuit where RLC are not connected parallel to each other. Here what happened? Here R and L connected in series, but C comes in parallel with that. So this is different circuit than this particular circuit. Here R, L, C are in three different branches. So here we have two branches in which one branch has R and L in series and C. So from this circuit, how to find out the resonant frequency. Okay, now this is called a tank circuit where we have this kind of connection. Now here we have to find out the admittance of first branch, then second branch, that is the total admittance y1 plus y2. So here it is connected in series, so rs plus jxl, and admittance means 1 by that, and here this capacitance is nothing but minus jxc. So capacitance value is minus jxc, we can write, so that is 1 by minus jxc. Okay, so from this we can find out that we can solve this one, and we can separate the real part and imaginary part. Okay, then we got this particular expression. Now the main point of resonance is the imaginary part must be equal to 0. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to take this and we have to make this imaginary part equal to 0, and if we solve, we will get omega r equal to root over of 1 by LC minus r square divided by L square radian per second. So this becomes omega 0, omega r, resonant frequency for this tank circuit, or F r equal to 1 by 2 pi root of 1 by LC minus R square by L square. Now see here, these two expressions are different. Here we have this particular term comes into picture. Okay. So that this is you have to remember. Okay, that for if this is parallel connection is different, So you have to find out the total admittance and make your imaginary part equal to 0. From that you can find out what is the value of omega. From that you can find out resonant frequency. Now if ideal tank circuit means RS equal to 0, then what happens? If RS equal to 0, so this term will be 0, then FR equal to 1 by 2 pi root of 1 by LC. Right? So that we can find out. That means RS 0, so we have 1 by JXL plus 1 by minus JXC. Then this is the only term. So this coefficient of imaginary part you have to make it 0. So from that you can find out. That is the same as the series resonance circuit. Okay. Or RLC. 3 are connected in 3 different bunch in parallel connection. But when it is not like that, resonant frequency is different. So this part you have to remember. Now the lowest current from the source occurs at the resonant frequency, because here resistance become maximized because of parallel circuit. Okay, so here what happened in parallel RLC circuit, the lowest current from the source occurs at the resonant frequency of a parallel circuit, hence it is called rejector circuit. And series circuit is called acceptor circuit. Okay, where they are getting the maximum current and Z equal to minimum R value. At resonance, the current in the branches of the parallel circuit can be many times greater than the supply current. The factor of magnification is also called quality factor, or Q. Now at the resonant frequency of a resonant parallel network, the impedance is wholly resistance. Okay, the value of the impedance is known as dynamic resistance or dynamic impedance, that is equal to R. For series RLC circuit, it will be minimum. For parallel RLC circuit, it will be maximum. Okay. Now say one problem. This is a parallel circuit. So resonant frequency 1 by 2 pi root of LC. This is connected 3 branches. So this formula is applicable. So you got this value. Now XL equal to, you can find out, right? Now from that we can find out Q value R by XL. Okay, for parallel circuit, for series RLC, that is XL by R. Bandwidth you can find out FR by Q. Okay, if you got bandwidth, you can find out lower cutoff frequency, higher cutoff frequency, that is equal to resonant frequency minus half bit bandwidth by half, or resonant frequency plus bandwidth by half, plus bandwidth, half of the bandwidth. Now IT is the maximum current that you can find out, V by R. We got this value. Now say another problem. Here we have R, L and C is given. We can calculate omega R is nothing but 1 by root of LC. R, L, C are 3 branches, separate branches, so no problem. Q we can find out R by omega R, L. Bandwidth omega R by Q, then you can find out omega and omega 2. So same thing that we have done for this one. Here we did for F values, here we did for omega values. Okay. Now at omega equal to omega R, Y equal to 1 by R or Z. So equal to R equal to 8 kilo ohm, that is the maximum value. Okay. So I0 equal to V by Z, that we got the I0 current value. Now at omega equal to omega R, what is the power dissipated? That will be nothing but half of I square into R. So we got this particular value of power dissipated at omega equal to omega R. Okay. Now say this is a circuit where we have parallel circuit, capacitor and resistance, inductor and resistance. So this, for this particular circuit we have to find out the omega R value. Now for this, we have, for parallel circuit we have to find out the admittance. So Y equal to, this is j omega 0.1, 1 by that, so it will be this one. Okay, 1 by R. Okay, and this is 2 plus j omega 2, okay, 2 plus j omega 2, 1 by that. So that becomes the admittance. Now we have to solve it, separate the real part and imaginary part, and we have to make real imaginary part equal to 0. That is the resonant condition. So if you solve it, we will get the value of omega z r. Okay. So for any kind of, if the circuit is R L C in three different branches, no problem. We can use omega r formula directly. Otherwise, we have to find out the omega r value formula. Just writing the total admittance, then separate real and imaginary part. Make the imaginary part equal to zero. Find out what is the value of omega. Now resonant frequency using impure inductor, that is the formula 1 by 2 pi root of 1 by LC minus RS by L whole square, that already we have seen for this tank circuit. For this tank circuit here, RS by L whole square. Okay, so that is also called resonant frequency using impure inductor, where L is the inductance of the coil, C is the parallel capacitance, and Rs is the DC resistive value of the inductor coil. Now these are the comparison study. So resonant frequency series parallel, basically 1 by root of LC, 1 by root of LC. Q factor is XL by R or 1 by omega 0 CR or XC by R. But for quality factor for parallel circuit, that is R by XL or R by XC. Bandwidth is nothing but resonant frequency divided by quality factor. For both cases the same. Half power frequency we can find out using two different formulas. Okay, and omega 1, omega 2 we can find out using resonant frequency plus minus bandwidth by 2. Okay, now say application. It has wide range of applications. Now one of the application is say in RF circuits, that is called tuning. That means we have say several frequencies are there. Now if we have resonant LC circuit which has say resonant frequencies at 1000 kilohertz, then what among all those frequencies it will only select this 100 kilohertz only at the at its output. Okay, it will reject other all frequencies. Now another application is tuned amplifier. Now a tuned amplifier is a circuit that amplifies signals within a specified band. Okay. Typically a parallel resonant circuit is used in conjunction with an amplifier to achieve the selectivity of the frequency. In terms of general operation, input signals with frequencies that range over a wide band are accepted on the amplifier input and amplified. The function of resonant circuit is to allow only a relatively narrow band of those frequencies to be passed on. That means say at input of the, this is an amplifier, very wide range frequency is coming and it is amplified, but using a tank circuit or RLC parallel circuit, it is selecting a particular frequency. That means tuning a frequency, for that we require resonance concept. And we can have application in antenna input and to a receiver. Now radio signals are fed from a transmitter via electromagnetic waves and propagate through the atmosphere. When the electromagnetic waves cut across the receiving antenna, small voltages are induced. Out of all the wide range of electromagnetic frequencies, only one frequency or a limited band of frequencies must be extracted. For that we have to use again resonance conditions. So antenna receiving all the frequencies, coupling with some transformer, you are getting a parallel resonant circuit L and C. Then this will be the receiver input. It will receive the particular range of frequencies only. That will be decided by the resonant circuit. Okay. Another example is a signal reception and separation in TV receiver. So before the output of the video amplifier to the picture tube, the audio signal is removed by a 4.5 megahertz band stop filter called a wave trap. Okay, that means say we are getting a video signal, video plus audio signal here. After that what happens, we have to stop using band stop type filter or a resonator circuit. It stops frequency up to 4.5 megahertz and passes the other, which is the video, to play in the cathode tube. Okay, and the audio frequency. So it will another audio amplifier using that audio range of frequency, that is say it will pass up to 4.45 megahertz for the audio signal to be played in the sound in the microphone, the speaker. Okay, so that means basically what happened, video signal has video and audio, but those are having different frequencies, so it is blocking the audio signal and supplying the or passing the video signal to play in the cathode tube or in some other display devices, and audio signal is passing through the speaker to play the audio. So this is how this is done by using the resonant circuit once again. Okay, or say basically a RLC series circuit can act as a bandpass filter or band stop filter, depend on their connections, how they are operating. So from where you are taking the output, from resistance or from LC, depend on that. So that kind of filter circuit I will discuss in next lecture. Okay, so here we can use resonant circuits or some filter circuit. Okay, so that is the application of resonance phenomenon in TV receivers, radio, to select radio channel, we have to use this resonance condition, tuned amplifier. So these are the applications. So this is the basic concepts of resonance in AC circuit. Okay. Now try to practice some problems related to resonance. Okay. So thank you so much.